how through dreams, through unholy, first to make the man unholy, and then he destroys that man. That's what we read in this book. Same thing happened to now what we have read in the book of Isaiah 37 of Hezekiah. So when Hezekiah received so much of deliverance from cancer, and he is going to live for 15 years, what he is supposed to do? He is supposed to recognize the Lord who has healed him and enter into holiness, meaning enter into the presence of God, celebrating the presence of God. That's why in the book of Zephaniah, chapter 3, verse 15, it is written, the Lord is amidst us, so you will see destruction no more. When the Lord is with you, the enemy cannot come near you. That is called the holiness. Holiness means doesn't mean that you have to be holy, holy, act right, or you have to do something. No. Holiness means basically moving with the presence of God, moving in the company of God, doing the will of God, preparing oneself, building up oneself, whether I talk, whether I eat, as we read in 1 Corinthians chapter 10, verse 31. Whatever you do, eat or drink, glorify God in everything. That is, you build up your life like that. Now, having received so much of healing and deliverance, suddenly he hears the Babylonians are coming. Why they are coming? To see how great the God of Hezekiah. He knew of glorifying God. As soon as the Babylonians come, he is acting, come, what do you want? You want to please them. You want to make them to sit over. Instead of keeping the Lord above, he is now keeping the enemies. And he goes and shows them out, look, I have this gold, look, silver. The prophet Isaiah came to him and said, stupid guy, who healed you? Who brought you out? Your mighty God, merciful Savior. And you have no grace to honor him. When the enemies came, it is my Lord who healed me. I tell you, what all you showed, the same enemy will carry them all from you. God gives us deliverance that we will deliver people. We will magnify the Lord. We will move into holiness. That's what happened to Daniel. When they said, you drink all this, eat, he said, I'm sorry. He kept up his holiness. He is not willing to defile himself. Means he is not willing to do anything that will hurt the presence of God that is in him. That is called holiness. Holiness means to preserve, to move around with the Lord. That's why the Lord said, the enemy is coming behind me, but he has no power over me. John 14:30, he said, the ruler of the world is coming behind me, but he has no power over me. Because I move in the presence of the Father. Praise the Lord. I'll take you to the book of Job. The Lord is asking. Job gets the revelation that the Lord is calling Job when he lost everything. The only power that will keep him always in the presence of the Lord is to call upon the Lord. Whatever may be the disturbance comes, it is through life of prayer he should be able to protect the presence of God in him. So the deliverance comes from holiness. Holiness means keeping alive the presence of God, moving around the presence of God, and that happens through the life of prayer. Verse 13 onward, they spend their days in wealth and in a moment go down to the grave. This is what the world, yet they say to God, depart from us, for we do not desire the knowledge of your ways. When you don't seek God, When you don't pray it, you tell, Lord, go away from us. We are satisfied with the drinks we have. We are satisfied with the pleasures we get from the world. We are satisfied with the relationship we have with the people, the friendship we have. We are satisfied with the work we have. We don't need you. The enemy will work. He will not allow you to raise your eyes to God. From inside, the enemy will tell you, depart from us. We do not desire the knowledge of your ways. When you don't pray, this is what will happen. The knowledge of God will be stopped. When you stop praying, the knowledge of God will be stopped. And then the knowledge of the evil will come. Oh, one guy will come and tell you, Arre, yesterday I had such a drink, man. It's very so sweet, you know. I took 3-4 beck, nothing happened, man. Even without soda, they feel so proud about it. That is the great thing. Aha, so today we will see. Today I will also come, we will have a wonderful time. What do they call it? Wonderful time. We will have great time. All wrong, what God can give it to us, all the terms, all this kind of thing will be given to the enemy's games. And man, I have brought the cigar from Britain, and nothing, you don't feel at all. You can go on at a time. 10 I finished, man. I see. I am great, man. I will finish 20 and show you. Let's see in the evening. Come on. You go from death, pit to pit. The enemy slowly moves you like a zero. From there, you are in 5. Little time you are praying, Satan has brought you to 0. From 0, he will take you to -5, -10. Again, to come back even to this 5, you have to come back -20 and again 5. You become very far from God. The enemy goes on, brings one after another. First he brings maybe the spirit of smoking cigar, spirit of drinking alcohol and talking, speaking ill of others. Slowly spirit of prostitution, spirit of all, one by one. They go on, tie him, tiger. So, the first thing to bind us, the enemy will say, we don't need your knowledge. We don't need your ways. What, mommy? Going on praying. Stop praying. What is this? If you want, you go and pray. No, son. If you want me, I have seen you dying in your sin. If you don't pray, if you don't have light, what is left out is darkness. If I am your mommy, if I am your daddy, I have to lead you. If you love me, this is the way we have to show. That's why a beautiful sentence is given in the book of Proverbs, chapter 22. Verse 6, train up a child in the way he should go. Train up the child not as you wish to go, or as you desire to go, or as the child wants to go. No. The word of God says, train up the child in the ways he should go. There is a way for the child to go, which God has kept. And when he is old, he will not depart from it. When he becomes old, so when he is young, you show what is the way of the Lord, and then he will not go. We continue Job chapter 21. What are the ways through which the enemy binds man? Removing him from holiness. Removing the person from the presence of God. Verse 15. Who is this Almighty that we should serve him? And what profit do we have if we pray to him? The next thought the enemy will bring to defile you, to take away the holiness from you, to bind you in bondage. What he will teach you? He will put this kind of thought. What is this Almighty? We should serve him. What profit will I get? If I pray, will I get this? If I work only, I can man. If I don't work, will you feed? Will anybody give me money? This kind of thoughts the enemy will put. What profit will I get if I pray? Simply you are going on telling me, pray, pray, pray. I caught up and prayed. I went for the Sunday mass enough. Mommy, please don't disturb me. Daddy, please don't do. Why? The enemy is roaring like a lion. All that he wants is to bind us and bind our children. We get fed up. I'll let him go whatever he wants. No. You and I are given a mission till the end of our life. Monica, husband became drunkard. When she went to the priest Ambrose, Ambrose said, this woman, hello, this man, if he would have fallen into the hand of some another woman, that woman would have left him long ago. But God gave this man into your hands that you may win his soul. Until then, that drunkard husband was a burden. From that moment, when she heard from Ambrose, it became a mission for her. So she used to search for him where he has fallen and bring him gently, put oil to his feet, taking care of him. And by that time, his liver, heart all gone to the alcohol. He was dying. You know what he said? Monica, I would have died like a pig in the dirt. But today, I'm dying like an angel at the lap of an angel. You saved me. Monica says, there is no greater joy. I did not get gold from my husband. I did not get any house from my husband. But I am happy I could save the soul of my husband to the Lord. Soon the son became. By the time mother was 65 years. You know what is the meaning of age 65? By the time you get knee pain, you can't walk properly. And that is age. The son is a grown-up son, but drunkard. That 65-year-old lady raised her hands and prayed because she knew the body, if it is given to the evil, it can become instruments of destruction. On the other hand, the same body, if it is given to God, according to Romans 12:2, offer your bodies as a living sacrifice to God, the same body will become power, instruments of power, instruments that will destroy the evil. Yes, in the book of Exodus chapter 16, when Moses raised the hands for many hours, as long as the hands were raised up, the enemy Amalekites were destroyed. We read in the book of Daniel chapter 6 verse 10, as long as the knees of Daniel were on prayer, the lions could not even come near Daniel. He bound the mouths of the lion. Every organ of yours, your body, if it is given to the holiness, If it is moving with the presence of God, it has decided, I made it clear, whether I anything achieve or not, this one thing I will achieve. What is that? I will always glorify God through whatever I talk, whatever I do, wherever I go, let anything happen, I will glorify my God. That is the purpose of my life. If you make it, you will see every instrument, even the moment you look at people, people will get repentance. They will be crying. Your body will be a mighty vessel. No wonder they are taking the parts of St. Anthony all over the world. Because that part has lived for God. That's what we read in the book of 2 Kings. Once some people brought a dead man to Elisha, and they found Elisha is already dead. So they did not know what to do. Then some people said, why can't you go and pray to the graveyard? So those people are carrying the graveyard. It was a lonely place. Some thieves, they saw four people are going slow, so we can catch these four people. Their pockets will be full. So they wanted to catch. So they, by the time they reached the graveyard, they saw the thieves are coming. They left the dead body on the graveyard of Elisha and they ran away. The moment the bone of this dead man touched the graveyard of the great holy man Elisha, that fellow also got life. He also started to run. That's what the Bible says. The presence of God. Your body can become a mighty vessel of God. You need not search anywhere. You offer your body in holiness to your God. There is no other greater power than you. Wherever you go, you will become instruments of healing and deliverance. And that is the desire of God. That is the greatest achievement. You can give it to the Lord to glorify God, that you have protected yourself from the power of the enemy. And you moved all your life around the presence of God, and you have surrendered your life to do the will of God. Yes. That's what we read here in Job says, when the evil attacks, they say in verse 15, who is this Almighty? What profit we get out of it? This is the evil thought the enemy will bring into the life of the children of God and keep the Lord away from their lives, whereby the enemy will bind them with sickness, with bondage, with all kinds of evil. And then third technique we'll go through, verse 16. Indeed, their prosperity is not in their hand. The moment they fall into the hands of the enemy, all that God gave it to them will be used by the enemy, used for the enemy. When the prodigal son went away from the father, took all the money of the father, the enemy, what did he do? He removed all the money. All the money which the father, prosperity, everything is gone for the evil. For the evil world to drink, to move around with the prostitutes, to play cards, to go and watch this and that, go here, there. All that is gone. He comes to realize at the end of his stage, as long as what the father gave him was with him, he had food. The moment he lost, made it zero of what he got from the father, he was thrown into the pigs. Even what the pigs were getting, they were not getting. They will get plenty of money, but when you play around, their bank account will become zero. Your prosperity, he will show As long as you have a job, you have a big business, you have a car, you move around, this and that. But everything will become just sucked out by the enemy. And next is, the counsel of the wicked is far from me. The counsel of the Lord will not be available for them. When you move away from the Lord, the counsel, God's counsel, God guiding, we read in Psalm 37, I will keep my eyes over your eyes and I will counsel you. We read in the book of Isaiah chapter 30 verse 20 to 22, it is written that though you eat the bread of suffering and the water of affliction, your God will not simply throw you away. He will talk to you from within. This is the way. Walk in it. Yes, God will continue to. When you move with Him, problems will move with you. But God will talk and counsel you, lead you. But when you move away from the presence of God, when you move away from the holiness, when you defile yourself, when you allow the enemy to defile you, what will happen? The counsel of the Lord will be heard no more. You can't hear the voice of God. My dear friends, Sangamam Plus TV is God's gift for you for our times. Like, comment, share and subscribe. God will do wonders in your life. Praise the Lord.